हाँ मैम ज्वाइन हो गया हूँ, ज्वाइन हो गया। ठीक है
गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन, इफ यू कैन हियर मी प्लीज टाइप एल एन सी। ओके, विल बी स्टार्टिंग इन लाइक 2 मिनट्स। गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, लास्ट क्लास वी स्टार्टेड विथ that we were doing core data, right? So let's continue our discussion. We finished with the general features regarding Phylum core data's various classes. Yes, we also did the last point that we did was reproduction, right? So let's move ahead now. Please open your books. We need to very quickly finish the parts of chondrichthyes, osteichthyes. Yes. So the last point that we did was, I think, extra embryonic membranes, right? That was the last point, I think, that we did. All right. So the new point that we are now going to start with is a fresh point, which is about the skull. Skull. So, you know, skull in the back, the posterior portion of the skull, the part of the skull behind. Okay. So if this is the skull, right, this area of the skull is called the occiput or occipital bone. Okay, it's called occiput or occipital bone, right? So occiput or occipital bone in the skull has areas like this, has swellings. The swellings in the occipital bone is called occipital condyle. Okay, occipital condyles. Yeah, so occipital condyles are small swellings, bony swellings, which are present in the occipital bone. They are present in the occipital bone of the skull. They primarily help in aligning or holding the skull with respect to the vertebral column. Okay, it gives stability to the skull. So the first group is chondrichthyes, second group is osteichthyes. So the thing is skull, dono mein humko likhna hai, no occipital condyles. So they don't have, there are no occipital condyles. No occipital condyles. Yes, there are no occipital condyles. In chondrichthyes and in osteichthyes, no occipital condyles. Then in amphibia, the skull has two occipital condyles. In amphibia, the skull has two occipital condyles. Okay, so such a skull is called a dicondylic skull. A dicondylic skull. Okay. Or skull with two occipital condyles. Skull with two occipital condyles. Dicondylic skull. Okay. इन रेप्टाइल्स, इन रेप्टिलिया देयर इज अ मोनोकोंडाइलिक स्कल. इन रेप्टिलिया द स्कल इज मोनोकोंडाइलिक. मोनोकोंडाइलिक का मतलब है स्कल विथ ओनली वन ऑक्सीपिटल कोंडाइल. इवन इन एव्स देर इज अ मोनोकोंडाइलिक स्कल. सो टू स्मॉल एलिवेशंस कमिंग फ्रॉम द बेस ऑफ द ऑक्सीपिटल बोन इज कॉल्ड ऑक्सीपिटल कोंडाइल. In amphibia, there is a dicondylic skull. In reptiles and apes, there is monocondylic skull. And in mammals, there is a dicondylic skull. Mammals have a dicondylic skull. So there is a dicondylic skull in mammals. So amphibians and mammals have dicondylic skull. Reptiles and birds have monocondylic skull. And chondrichthyes and osteichthyes, they don't have any occipital condyles. Okay, the horizontal line, please complete the point. All right, the next point again related to the brain now.
Sir, can you show the previous speech, sir, please?
Amphibians and mammals have dicondylic skull, and amphibians and mammals have dicondylic skull. Reptiles and birds have monocondylic skull. Okay, I think I was very, very slow. Yeah. All right. So we move on to the next point. The next point is about cranial nerves. So, what are cranial nerves? Come on in the chat box, tell me what are cranial nerves? Bataiye. क्रेनियल नर्व्स चैट बॉक्स में बताइए. वेरी गुड जय, वेरी गुड निरंजन, बाकी लोग, श्रवणी, वेरी गुड. श्रेया, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. सो क्रेनियल नर्व्स आर नर्व्स विच इमर्ज फ्रॉम द ब्रेन. Yeah, spinal nerves are nerves which emerge from the spinal cord. Now, in chondrichthyes, in osteichthyes, and in amphibia, chondrichthyes, osteichthyes, and amphibia, there are 10 pairs. There are 10 pairs of cranial nerves. Okay? In chondrichthyes, osteichthyes, and amphibia, there are 10 pairs of cranial nerves. Whereas in Ram, Ram kya hai? Reptiles, apes, and mammalia, there are 12 pairs of cranial nerves. So humans also have 12 pairs of cranial nerves. When we're doing study of tissues, I taught you that. 12 pairs of cranial nerves. Now don't write anything, that point is over. Don't write anything, just want to teach you something first. So there is a part which connects the forebrain with the hind brain. Okay. That part in between is called the midbrain. Right? Now midbrain looks something like this. Yeah. It is broad and then it is tapering downwards. Now on the posterior surface, also known as the dorsal surface of the midbrain, some animals have two swollen bodies. And some animals have four swollen bodies. The upper two are identical and the lower two are smaller and they are identical. Okay, so this one present in the dorsal part of the midbrain, there are two bodies. That is why it's called corpora. Corpora is a plural of corpus. Corpus in English, in Latin means body. Corpora. Bigemina, corpora bigemina, bi का मतलब होता है two, and this is corpora, four are there, so quadri, gemini का मतलब होता है pair, gemina, Gemini is a star sign of a pair or duality, twins. Yeah. Now, corpora bigemina is this structure. The swollen parts are called colliculi. Swollen parts are called colliculi. तो जहाँ पे चार होते हैं वहाँ पे दो आपको colliculi दिखेंगे. एक ऊपर, तो इसको बोलते हैं superior colliculi. और एक नीचे, जिसको हम बोलते हैं inferior colliculi. Superior colliculi and inferior colliculi. Superior colliculi deals with visual reflexes. Now, what is a visual reflex? Now, if you are watching a cricket match or a tennis match, correct? कभी अगर टेनिस मैच को मतलब जब यू नो अगर आप टीवी पे देख रहे हो तो जो वहां पे ऑडियंस रहती है उसका मुंडी है ना बहुत moving. That's a visual reflex. Am I audible now? So, in some vertebrates, dorsal part of the midbrain has a pair of rounded structures, a pair of rounded structures called colliculi. Yes, which help in visual reflexes. Yeah, visual reflex ka example aapko diya. Your eyes gaze or fixed on the moving object, which helps in visual reflexes. Because there is only one pair of bodies, corpora bigemina. This structure is called corpora bigemina. Corpora bigemina. Right? Whereas in some organisms, dorsal part of the midbrain has two pairs of rounded structures. What are the two pairs of rounded structures? The first one is called superior colliculi. This deals with visual reflexes. Okay. And the next one is called inferior colliculi. They deal with auditory reflexes. Visual reflexes and auditory reflexes. Auditory matlab sound. So suppose aap kahin pe ja rahe ho aur kisi ne aapka naam pukara. You don't sit and analyze. Automatically aapka mundi turn ho jayega, right? Kahin aap chal rahe ho aur kisi ne aapka naam pukara, correct? So that is auditory reflexes. So this structure made up of four bodies जिसमें से दो tentacle होते हैं is called, अगर ऊपर वाले structure को corpora bigemina बोलते हैं तो इसको बोलते हैं corpora quadrigemina. Corpora quadrigemina. Okay, midbrain is the part of the brain which connects the forebrain with the hindbrain. Okay, so this is the dorsal part. Kuch animals mein aise do swollen bodies hoti hai aur kuch mein char swollen bodies hoti hai. Do badi hoti hai aur do choti hoti hai, correct? बिकॉज इसका जो स्ट्रक्चर है वो क्या बोलते हैं, ब्रॉड अपवर्ड्स एंड टेपरिंग डाउनवर्ड्स. सो दीज विल बी कॉल्ड सुपीरियर कॉलिक्युलाई एंड दीज आर कॉल्ड इन्फीरियर कॉलिक्युलाई. और क्योंकि ये दो ही है, दे आर जस्ट कॉल्ड कॉलिक्युलाई. कम ऑन, कॉन्ड्रिक थाइज एंड ऑस्टिक थाइज में दो बार आपको लिखना है. कॉन्ड्रिक थाइज एंड ऑस्टिक थाइज हैव कॉर्पोरा बाइजेमिना. Corpora bigemina. चलो ये पूरा पैराग्राफ विद द डायग्राम दो बार लिखना है. Once you are done, just tell me so that I can. Fishes have corpora bigemina. So the feature is midbrain. The feature is midbrain. The feature or property is midbrain. Please write twice. Singular of colliculus. Colliculi is colliculus. Then directly in mammals, you are going to write corpora quadrigemina. In mammals, you will be writing corpora quadrigemina. कमांड मैमल्स में कॉर्पोरा क्वाड्रीजेमिना का पूरा डिटेल लिखिए. मैमल्स में आप ये वाले लिखोगे कॉर्पोरा क्वाड्रीजेमिना. डन. नाउ यू आर वेटिंग फॉर एवरीबडी टू राइट डन सो दैट आई कैन टेल यू द रिसर्च क्वेश्चन इज You have to find in amphibians, reptiles and birds. इसमें कॉर्पोरा क्वाड्रीजेमिना होता है कि बायजेमिना होता है. तो ये जगह छोड़ देना है क्वेश्चन मार्क करके. ड्रॉ अ लाइन टू कंप्लीट द पॉइंट. लास्ट 2 मिनट्स. Okay, then since we are on the process of doing the brain, let's move ahead. The next are olfactory lobes or sense of smell. Olfaction ka matlab hota hai olfaction. Olfactory lobes. Olfaction का मतलब होता है sense of smell. So lobes in the brain which helps in the sense of smell. Okay, olfactory lobes in the brain having a sense of smell in the brain. In chondric thighs and in osteic thighs, both of them, they have a very well developed sense of smell. Very well developed olfactory lobes. Very well developed olfactory lobes. Hence, they have a strong sense of smell. Yes, so sharks can smell very. They have a very powerful sense of smell. Chondric thighs and osteic thighs mein ye likhna hai, very well developed. Amphibians and reptiles mein, as compared to fishes, generally wo smell itna acha nahi hota hai, but phir bhi wo humans se to better hi hota hai. So moderately well developed olfactory lobes. Amphibians or reptiles may moderately well developed. Now this is most important. In apes, the olfactory lobes are very poorly developed. Matlab अच्छे नहीं होते हैं, वेरी पुअरली डेवलप्ड. एंड वन इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट विच इज आस्क्ड, हेंस बर्ड्स कांट स्मेल. सो मोस्ट ऑफ द बर्ड्स कांट स्मेल. नाउ बर्ड्स कैन ऑल्सो पॉलिनेट फ्लावर्स. So a flower which is brightly colored, color uska acha hai, but usme smell nahi hai. Insect ko smell aur color dono chahiye. Birds smell nahi kar sakte. To flowers pollinated by birds, they don't have a sweet sense of smell. What about mammals? As compared to the others, they also have a poorly developed olfactory lobe, but they can smell. Ab mammals may be thode thode exceptions hai, jaise dogs hai ya kuch so kuch मैमल्स है जिनका सेंस ऑफ स्मेल बहुत वेल डेवलप्ड है. बट इन जनरल अगर मैं बोलूँ तो मैमल्स का ऑल्फैक्ट्री लोब्स पुअरली डेवलप्ड है, बट दे कैन स्मेल. birds can't smell only, itna poorly developed hai. If you compare our sense of smell and shark or other fishes ka sense of smell, they are better. That is better. So olfactory lobes is the next point. With the help of a horizontal line, please complete the point. Once you finish this, just type. Why is the evolution going backwards in olfactory? First of all, you have to understand that evolution is not always going to give you a linear progression. Okay? Remember, and this is very important, evolution is a random process. Okay? It is not well defined. You cannot 100% predict. We try to analyze the effects of evolution by studying evolution, but every time I'm not going to get a progressive or a regressive. मतलब जरूरी नहीं है कि मुझे दिखे. जैसे कॉन्डाइल्स देखो, कॉन्डाइल्स नहीं था, फिर एम्फीबियंस में दो कॉन्डाइल आया, फिर रेप्टाइल बर्ड में एक ही कॉन्डाइल, फिर वापस से मैमल में दो कॉन्डाइल. तो यहाँ पे आपको कोई रिलेशनशिप ऑफ प्रोग्रेशन नहीं समझ में आता. दिस प्रूव्स दैट एवोल्यूशन इज अ रैंडम प्रोसेस. ऑल्फैक्टरी लोब्स हो गए. देन वी मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट, अदर सेंस ऑर्गन्स. Other sense organs. Now, when I look at fishes, उनके साइड में एक ब्लैक कलर की बॉडी होती है, एक ब्लैक कलर की लाइन होती है ऐसे. It runs along the length of the, yeah, this is length of the fish body. This is found in chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. So, what is found here is this. The sense organ in chondrichthyes and osteichthyes, special ones, are called lateral line sense organ. Lateral line sense organs. Lateral line sense organ का मतलब क्या है? एक line जैसा दिखता है on either side, so that's why they call lateral line sense organs. And what do the lateral line sense organs do? They detect changes in water current. They detect changes in water current. They detect changes in water current. So lateral line sense organs are found in chondrichthyes, osteichthyes. Please write it twice. ठीक है. देन अदर सेंस ऑर्गन्स में एम्फीबियंस में क्या है? एम्फीबियंस में कोई लैटरल लाइन सेंस ऑर्गन नहीं होता. सो फॉर ईयर, कान के लिए दे हैव मॉडरेटली डेवलप्ड, मॉडरेटली डेवलप्ड टिम्पैनम. या मॉडरेटली डेवलप्ड टिम्पैनम. सो उनके हेड के पास देर इज अ सर्क्यूलर पैच लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, या जो मेम्ब्रेन की तरह काम करता है. इट हेल्प्स इन डिटेक्शन ऑफ साउंड. सो टिम्पैनम, इट हेल्प्स इन डिटेक्शन ऑफ साउंड्स, डिटेक्ट साउंड्स और चेंजेस और वाइब्रेशन इन एयर बोल सकते हो आप. Sound is nothing but a vibration in air. Then when we come to reptiles, reptiles have a well-developed tympanum. So they can hear. Well-developed tympanum. In fact, even birds have a well-developed tympanum. So reptiles and birds, both of them have a well-developed tympanum. Okay. In mammals, the tympanum and the structure around it gets modified. So mammals have a well-developed ear. Well-developed ear for hearing. And this ear has three parts. External ear for collection of sound. Yes? So external ear is modified for collection of sound. Then there is middle ear. Middle ear is for amplification. Agar kam sound aata hai, to wo usko amplify karta hai. Amplification of sound. Middle ear is for amplification of sound. And the third one is called internal ear. Internal ear sound ko samajhne mein madad karta hai. Internal ear is for perception of sound. Perception ka matlab hota hai samajhna. Perception of sound. So that is how well developed ear is. So this completes our point on other sense organs. Please wind up this point. And once you're done, please write done so that I know. Alright, the next point is, I think majority of you all have finished. So the next point is special sense organs. Okay, now special sense organ matlab special areas pe hi likhne wale hum, sab jagah pe nahi hoga wo. Okay, for example, special sense organ. One commonly found in chondrichthyes. Okay. The one which is commonly found in chondrichthyes is a dilated area called ampulla. It was discovered by a gentleman called Lorenzini. So it's called ampulla of Lorenzini. Very commonly found in sharks and rays. They detect electric currents in water. So they detect, the ampulla of Lorenzini detects electric current or electric fields in water. Okay. Electric current, say better word, electric field. Okay. Ampulla of Lorenzini that is found in chondrichthyes. Then in reptiles there is a special sense organ. We are still on the nervous system, so you see the sense organ. Reptiles have a special sense organ called Jacobson's organs, and Jacobson's organ actually help them in detecting vibrations and chemicals in air. Now this is classically found in reptiles. It is found in some amphibians too. Okay, but amphibians or reptiles ke beech mein aayega ek option, to reptiles choose karenge. So if you've seen snake or movies वगैरह में तो दिखाते कि बार बार वो अपना जबान बाहर निकलता है. Yes, जैसे एक कोबरा है तो वो अपना टंग बाहर निकलता है. Yes, so वो Jacobson's organs, hello, the Jacobson's organs are the ones which detect vibrations and chemicals in air to identify, because snakes are almost blind, matlab they have a hazy picture of the world, clear nahi hota. So baki jagah sense organ mein dash kar do, ye dono jagah pe chondrichthyes aur reptilia mein ye special sense organs likh ke close the point. Okay, then we move on to something known as unique features, something which are found only in that group, which can also be classified as adaptations. ठीक है, वो जहां पे भी रहते हैं उसके लिए उन्होंने कैसे उनका बॉडी को अडेप्ट किया है और उसके वजह से कुछ यूनिक फीचर्स उसके उनके बॉडी में है. So what are those bodies? We'll see it from now. Chondrichthyes only have ampulla of Lorenzini. Very few osteichthyes have ampulla of Lorenzini. आपको आएगा तो आप ना लिखेंगे, because majority of the books have even no. Yes, they basically detect electrical fields in air, in water. Sorry. So here we are going to take up, because there are going to be more points. We are going to take up individual. ये इंडिविजुअल क्लासेस ऑब्वियसली हम लोग, लेकिन कॉन्ड्रिक्थाइज और ऑस्टिक्थाइज को साथ में पढ़ेंगे, बिकॉज दे बोथ बिलोंग टू फिशेस. दे हैव वेरी सिमिलर यूनिक फीचर्स और अडेप्टेशंस. सो सबसे पहले तो जो दोनों में होता है वो है स्ट्रीमलाइंड बॉडी. नाउ स्ट्रीमलाइंड बॉडी का मतलब क्या होता है पता है? I'll come back to this slide. Now suppose there is water, okay? अब ऐसा water है. Now I am passing something through and through. मतलब मैं समझो screen के बाहर से अंदर की तरफ जाके, okay? Screen के उस तरफ जाना है मुझे. सो इमेजिन जो तुम्हारा स्क्रीन है वो वाटर है, करेक्ट? अब तुमको बाहर से वाटर में पियर्स करके स्क्रीन के उस तरफ जाना है, राइट? नाउ आई हैव अ बॉल पेन, ओके, एंड आई हैव अ स्केल, प्लास्टिक स्केल. दे आर ऑफ द सेम मटीरियल, दे आर मेड अप ऑफ द सेम मटीरियल, ओके, and their weight is also the same, right? So tell me which one will be better or which one will have least resistance while passing through the water. So the idea is about, you know, being able to cut through the layers of water. Yes? Yeah, somebody told me, sir, streamline was already taught in 9th in physics. All right, then I don't think we should spend time on that. Basically, streamlined body ka matlab ye hota hai ki wo flat hoti hai unki body, theek hai? So rather than fish being cylindrical, unki body aisi flat hoti hai na dono taraf se. Wo dono taraf se flat hoti hai taki wo jo water body hai usme kam area ko cut karke aage badh sake. So both of them have a streamlined body. That means they are going to be tapering at both ends and they are generally flattened. Both of them have streamlined bodies for swift movement in water. Yes, they have a unique feature again, that they have gills for respiration. Osteichthyes also have gills for respiration because they are aquatic in nature. Next, they move with the help of fins. So they have fins for locomotion. So you see, there is, fins are not present in any other class. So they have fins for locomotion. Then in terms of sense organs, they have lateral line sense organs. So both of them will have lateral line sense organs. This will also have lateral line sense organs. Yes, then unique feature kya hai, matlab ye word aaya to aapko quadricthyes aana hi chahiye. Ampulla of Lorenzini, what is the function? It helps in detecting electrical currents in or electrical fields in water. Osteichthyes ka function kya hai, osteichthyes mein kya hai, air bladder, जिसको हम लोग स्विम ब्लैडर भी बोलते हैं. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस द ऑस्टिकथाइस विल नेवर सिंक, दे ऑलवेज फ्लोट, दे डोंट नीड टू कंटिन्यूसली स्विम. सो दीज आर यूनिक फीचर और अडेप्टेशंस ऑफ कॉन्ड्रिक्टाइज एंड ऑस्टिकथाइस विद द हेल्प ऑफ फिनिश दिस एंड वंस यू आर डन प्लीज इन्फॉर्म मी इन द चैट बॉक्स. Two people have finished, waiting for others' response. Last 1 minute. Okay. Then we come to amphibians. So what are the unique features or adaptations of amphibia? Sabse pehle, moist skin for respiration. Koi bhi vertebrate मॉइस्ट स्किन से रिस्पायर नहीं कर रहा है. सो मॉइस्ट स्किन फॉर रेस्पिरेशन, दैट मीन दे हैव क्यूटेनियस रेस्पिरेशन. ठीक है, दे हैव नो एग्जोस्केलेटन. बाकी सबके पास एग्जोस्केलेटन होता है, आउटर लेयर. दे डोंट हैव एनी एग्जोस्केलेटन, नो एग्जोस्केलेटन. दे ऑल्सो हैव अ बक्को फेरेंजियल ब्रीदिंग और ब्रक्को फेरेंजियल रेस्पिरेशन. दैट मीन्स एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेज कैन टेक प्लेस बिटवीन इट्स बकल कैविटी एंड फेरिंग्स ऑल्सो. एंड इफ दे ब्रीद दे हैव अ पॉजिटिव प्रेशर ब्रीदिंग विच इज अगेन नॉट फाउंड इन एनी ग्रुप. पॉजिटिव प्रेशर ब्रीदिंग. सो दैट इज अबाउट एम्फीबिया. रेप्टाइल्स में हमको क्या क्या पता है जो यूनिक फीचर है? रेप्टाइल्स का एक यूनिक फीचर है, दे हैव ड्राइड कॉर्निफाइड स्किन. सो इनका स्किन ड्राइड एंड कॉर्निफाइड होता है. ऐसा स्किन बाकी किसी ग्रुप में नहीं होता है. नेक्स्ट, सबके पास स्केल्स हो सकते हैं, बट एपिडर्मल रेप्टिलिया के पास एपिडर्मल स्क्यूट्स भी हो सकते हैं which are present on the back, epidermal scutes. Then another, Jacobson's organs. Yes, which is a unique feature of reptiles. Yes. Then, many reptiles are poisonous. So many reptiles are poisonous. And some of them undergo molting. Some undergo molting. Molting is when this animal breaks down the skin covering and tries to come out. So reptiles undergo molting. Ekdiasis bolte hain molting ko. Ekdiasis. Example, snake mein molting hoti hai. क्योंकि हम यूनिक के बारे में ही बात कर रहे हैं, तो रेप्टाइल्स में लेट्स टॉक अबाउट यूनिक रेप्टाइल. यूनिक रेप्टाइल्स, रेप्टाइल्स नॉर्मली हैव अ फोर चेम्बर्ड हार्ट, रादर थ्री चेम्बर्ड हार्ट विच इज इनकम्प्लीटली फोर चेम्बर्ड. यस, कंप्लीटली फोर चेम्बर्ड हार्ट इज प्रेजेंट इन. कम ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, टेल मी. Completely four-chambered heart is present in. Absolutely correct. Crocodile and tortoise. Crocodile and tortoise. Also, normally reptiles don't have a diaphragm. Diaphragm is a unique feature of mammals. Diaphragm is a muscular membrane which separates thorax, matlab chest, from the abdomen. Which separates thorax from abdomen. This is again a uniquely mammalian characteristic. This is also found in crocodile and alligators. So this is about reptiles and their unique features. Once you finish it, just in the comment section, tell me done so that I know that you're done. Great. So let's move on to now the unique features of aves or birds. Unique feature of aves or birds, or which helps in adaptation. Aves or birds also have a streamlined body, but their body is not flat. Yes, their streamlined body is for flying. So that is why you will see fishes are flatter, but birds are pointed at two ends. Streamlined body for flying. Then birds have a unique feature again, where they have exoskeleton made up of feathers. So a feathery exoskeleton is again a unique feature of birds. Then they have beaks, which does not have teeth. Edentulous beak. Edentulous beak matlab beak without teeth. Then in all birds, forelimbs are modified to form wings for flying. Forewings are modified to form wings. Yes. Then wings are attached to a bony structure. Wings are attached to a bony structure called keel. The bone which gives attachment to wings, that is called keel. Also, to make the body light, some unique features to make the body light. Okay, number one, pneumatic bones. Pneumatic bones to keep the body light. You know what pneumatic bones are? Bones are filled with hollow cavities. Pneumatic bones. Not only this, they don't have urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is absent. That means that is why they can't store any urine. So jaise hi banega waise, even if they are flying, it has to come out. Because they can't store their urine. Okay. The female birds don't want to become heavy. So female birds have only left ovary. This is very important. Only ovary on the left side with fallopian tubes or oviducts on the left side only. So have only left ovary and left oviduct. Matlab, sirf ek hi ovary aur ek hi oviduct hota hai. Yeah, one gonad only. Then tail is attached to a structure of the vertebral column, right? Wo bhi isme hi milta hai. It's pygo style. It's a bony structure towards the lower end of the vertebral column. Pygo style is for attachment to tail. Pygo style is for attachment to tail. It gives attachment to tail. Theek hai? They also lack copulatory organs. So many copulatory organs are absent in birds. Okay. Now birds actually tend to make noise. Okay. So like we have voice box, birds have a voice box. So they have a bony voice box. So what is the name of our voice box, children? What is the name of our voice box? Come on. Our voice box is called larynx. Their voice box is called syrinx. They have bony voice box, but they rarely have vocal cords. So because they don't have vocal cords, their sound is not as precise as ours. But yes, they can make noise. They can produce sounds. That's a bony voice box. Aditya, keel is a bony structure on which the wing is attached. Okay. They also have a bone called furcula. Furcula is also known as furcula. Furcula is also known as the wishbone. Okay. Birds have shoulder bones called clavicle. Okay. So there are two clavicles, two collar bones, jisko hum bolte hain. And that's connected to a bone in the center, which is called sternum. Sternum is also called the breast bone. So birds mein ye sab fuse ho jate hain to form a V-shaped bone or a U-shaped bone, formed by the union of U-shaped bone, formed by the union of fusion of clavicle and scapula. So there are different traditions. बर्ड के मीट खाने के बाद ये जो विश बोन होता है उसको फेंक के विश मांगी जाती थी. जैसे कुछ ट्रेडिशन, कुछ जगह पे ट्रेडिशन है कि कॉइन को पानी में डाल के विश मांगो, तो इसके लिए इसको विश बोन बोलते थे. फर्क्यूला नाम है उसका, ऑल्सो नोन एज विश बोन. सो दीज आर सो मैनी यूनिक फीचर्स ऑफ बर्ड. Once you finish it, just write it in the comment box so that we can two people have completed the rest, please complete and write in the comment box quickly. All right, let's move ahead. And the last part are the unique features of mammals. Yes, so what do we need to know about mammals? Number one, very important, Females have mammary glands. Females have mammary glands. Females have mammary glands. This is a unique feature only of mammals. Now, when I say mammary glands, they are functional mammary glands. Then mammals में external ear होता है. External ear जो हमको दिखता है उसको पिना भी बोलते हैं. So external ear or pinna is present. Now this is again found only in mammals. Okay. However, external ear or pinna is absent in aquatic mammals like dolphin, whale. Aquatic mammals mein pinna is absent, but baki sare mammals mein pinna is present. Then there is diaphragm. Diaphragm is a muscular separation. A muscular separation between thorax and abdomen. All mammals have diaphragm. Okay. Then another thing that we studied in the course was Haworthian system in the diaphysis of long bones. Haworthian system in the diaphysis of long bones. Yes, Haworthian system in the diaphysis of long bones. Then biconcave and enucleated RBC, again a unique feature of mammals. इसका एक एक्सेप्शन जो आपको सिखाया था, एक्सेप्ट कैमल्स एंड लामास. एक्सेप्ट कैमल्स एंड लामास. गुड, राइट. द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज दैट दे विल हैव हेयर. एनसीईआरटी में लिखा था ना, हेयर इज अ यूनिक फीचर. हेयर as exoskeleton. Hair
sorry,
hair as an exoskeleton. Then their middle ear has three bones. Middle ear has three ear ossicles. That's again found in mammals only. Ossicle matlab bones. The first one is malleus, hammer shaped incus, malleus, incus and stapes. Yeah, this helps in amplification of sound. सेवन सर्वाइकल वर्टिब्रा. सर्वाइकल का मतलब होता है नेक. सो देर आर सेवन सर्वाइकल वर्टिब्रा और सेवन वर्टिब्रा इन द नेक. सेवन सर्वाइकल वर्टिब्रे अगेन इज फाउंड इन mammals except two-toed sloth. And spiny anteater. Spiny anteater and two-toed sloth will have different cervical vertebrae. So these are the unique features of mammals. So we will stop here. We will take a break. And it is 4:55 in my watch. We will meet at 5 minutes past 5. 5 minutes past 5. Paragraph will not be accepted. Paragraph will not be accepted. Answer should be point wise only. ठीक है. नेक्स्ट फॉर 2 mark आंसर्स अनलेस दे हैव आस्क्ड स्पेसिफिक 2 points. मतलब इफ दे आस्क यू राइट डाउन द नेम, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल एक क्वेश्चन हमारे पेपर्स में मैंने डाला था कि गिव द क्लास एंड ऑर्डर ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स. सो क्लास ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स, ऑर्डर ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स. ठीक है, ये पर स्पेसिफिक 2 questions पूछे. अगर जनरल पूछा होगा, फॉर एग्जाम्पल गिव प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ प्लैटीहेलमिंथेस, अगर ये क्वेश्चन 2 mark के लिए आता है तो यू हैव टू राइट 4 points. क्वेश्चन इफ इज आस्क्ड फॉर 3 marks इट शुड हैव अ मिनिमम ऑफ 6 points. एंड इफ क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड फॉर 5 marks it should have a minimum of 10 points. Whatever are the number of marks, multiply that by 2. That should be your minimum number of points. You can elaborate more onto it. To score better, underline important words in your answers. Underline important words in your answers. Now, if they ask you what is the difference between, so for all questions which are of difference between, for all questions which are of difference between, it has to be in the table format only. If they ask you what is the difference between mitosis and meiosis, general paragraph nahi likhna hai, ek table banana hai. Aur agar wo 2 mark ke liye hoga to 4 points difference ke likhne hai, aur agar 3 mark ke liye hoga to 6 points different likhne hai. And even they don't ask, difference between should always include examples. Difference between should always include examples. Now, sometimes you are given choices between 2 questions. Yes? If you are given choices between 2 questions, choose a question whose answer is precise or specific. Okay? Matlab, for example, give 2 points, agar aisa question hoga. Ya give 3 things or enumerate. Ye sab questions are more specific. Generic question kya hota hai? Describe. Agar question hai describe, to aapko describe or versus write any 2 points aisa diya hua hai. So you should always choose the question which is more precise and specific in the answer, because you will end up saving time. Right? Start a new section on a new page. Start a new section on a new page. So this is very, very important as far as bio is concerned. Next time, whatever papers I go through, if I happen to check, if you have not written the question number properly, if you have jumbled up all the sections, सेक्शन बी में सेक्शन ए के क्वेश्चन लिखे हुए हैं वो सब के मार्क्स कट जाएंगे. डायग्राम्स अगर आपने पेन थोड़ा भी यूज किया है, ऑल्सो थ्रू आउट द पेपर यू कैन ओनली यूज वन इंक, यू कांट यूज मल्टीपल इंक्स इन योर क्वेश्चन पेपर. सो बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल फॉर दैट. अगर आप ब्लैक से लिख रहे हो तो ब्लैक से ही कंटिन्यू करना है. ऑल राइट, ऑल आंसर शुड बी इन पॉइंट. इफ यू राइट आंसर इन पैराग्राफ यू विल गेट जीरो मार्क्स. इफ यू डोंट नो हाउ टू मेक अ पॉइंट, राइट एवरी सेंटेंस ऑन अ न्यू लाइन and make it a point. It has to be point wise. Underline important words. If you choose differentiate between, then has to be in the form of a table, and also include, always include examples. Whenever you are given a choice between two questions, choose the one which is more precise and specific in the answer rather than vague general answers, and write a new section in a new page. Now, does anyone have any query regarding this? Okay. Then you would have finished the table on core data, right? Leave two pages. Okay. Leave two pages. Then again, after leaving two, three pages, you come to a double page. Now we are going to start with non-chordates. Again, non-chordates में हम क्या करते हैं? Paragraph wise पढ़ते हैं, right? उसके बजाय हम क्या करने वाले? दो तीन को group करके पढ़ते हैं, जिसमें हमको एक transition मिलेगा. अच्छा, कभी दो, कभी तीन होंगे, कभी एक अकेला होगा, कभी दो होंगे, तो वो मैंने अपना teaching experience के हिसाब से transitions आपको देखने हैं, right? All right. Now for this table, you don't need a double page because there are only three groups. So ek single page mein hi, the title is going to be Comparative Analysis. Aapka table khatam hua. Table ke baad aapko do page chhodna hai. And then your title above the margin is going to be Comparative Analysis of Porifera, Cnidaria and Ctenophora. ये तीनों फाइलम हम करने वाले हैं, ठीक है? You know the drill. The first margin के अंदर होना चाहिए feature. Then it should be phylum Porifera, right? Then there is phylum Cnidaria, and then there is phylum Ctenophora. और ये डबल पेज में नहीं करना है, बिकॉज तीन ही है ना, छह होते तो हम डबल पेज पे कर रहे होते, ये तीन ही है तो इसको सिंगल पेज पे ही करो. तो इस ये होगा शीट वन. ऐसे फटाफट सिक्स शीट्स बनाइए. I'm giving you 5 minutes. Make 6 sheets and type done. Some preliminary information हम लोग डाल देंगे उसमें, जो already हमने table से पढ़े हुए हैं, correct? We will start this tomorrow, मतलब in the next class only the details. But preliminary information ये table में हम लोग अभी डालने वाले, तो आप लोग फटाफट 6 sheets बनाइए. come to the point wise analysis of next point wise analysis. We'll just introduce a couple of points, right? So the first one is meaning. I think you all should be knowing the meanings of it. The first feature is meaning. So what is the meaning of the word porifera? Come on. Porifera means, porifera means pore bearing. Yes. What is cnidaria? Having stinging cells. Okay. Those stinging cells are called cnidocytes. Iske liye uska naam hai cnidaria. Then what is ctenophora? They have, teno means teeth of a comb. They have teeth of the comb like projections. So that's the meaning of the word, comb like projections. Yes. Next point that we need to know is synonyms. Because they have a lot of pores, they are put under the group sponges. The earlier name was coelentrata. I explained that to you, right? Pehle ek group tha coelentrata jisme cnidaria aur ctenophora dono the. Fir ctenophora ko nikal ke ek naya group banaya gaya. So coelentrata. Their name synonyms, they are also called sea walnuts because they look like a walnut. They look sea walnuts or comb jellies. Sea walnuts or comb jellies. So those are the synonyms. Then the next one was germ layers. If you remember, sponges were parazoa. So they have no germ layers. Whereas cnidaria and ctenophora are what? They are diploblastic, having two germ layers, ectoderm and endoderm. Connected by mesoglia. Then level of organization. Next point is level of organization. They are at the cellular level of organization. They have cells, but they don't have any tissues. Whereas cnidaria and ctenophora, both of them have a tissue level of organization. They have tissues, but they don't have organs. That's their level of organization. Then body plan. What is the body plan? Their body plan here is cell aggregate body plan. Their body plan is cell aggregate, whereas the remaining two have a blind sac body plan. A blind sac body plan. Body plan ke baad next is body cavity. They are triploblastic. They are diploblastic, or they don't यहाँ पे तो कोई जर्म लेयर्स ही नहीं है, तो बॉडी कैविटी और सीलोम इज एब्सेंट। बाय बॉडी कैविटी आई मीन सीलोम, बॉडी कैविटी और सीलोम इज एब्सेंट। Then symmetry. Now sponges are mostly asymmetrical. They are mostly asymmetrical. I'll explain next class why are they asymmetrical. Few of them are radially symmetrical. Few of them are radially symmetrical, and larvae are also radially symmetrical. Matlab, when they are born, they are radially symmetrical. As they keep on growing up, they become asymmetrical. Then they here are mostly radially symmetrical. So they show radial symmetry. Ctenophora also shows radial symmetry, and these are exclusively radial symmetry. मतलब इनमें कोई भी exception नहीं होता radial symmetry का. यहाँ पे radial symmetry cnidaria में few can be asymmetrical also. So we can see that the life is changing from asymmetry to radial symmetry. Okay, so these are all different points. We just have to just add two more points. Please take a screenshot of this. Quickly take a screenshot so that we can move ahead. All right, then the next point is old classification. In old classification, they were put under the group Parazoa. Porifera were put under the group Parazoa. Then Cnidaria and Ctenophora were put under the group Radiata. Remember Protozoa and Metazoa. Metazoa was further classified as Parazoa and Eumetazoa. In Eumetazoa there was so group Eumetazoa and uske andar subgroup Radiata. सेम थिंग हैपन्स विथ नाइडेरिया ऑल्सो. तो यू सी बहुत सारी चीजें नाइडेरिया में एग्जैक्टली सेम है. इसके लिए तो पहले इनको एक ही ग्रुप में डाला हुआ था और उसके अंदर सब ग्रुप रेडिएटा. Then the last point for today before we wind up, and that is habitat. Where do they stay? Porifera are mostly marine. There are exceptions, and that can be us. Iske liye star dala hai. Freshwater sponge. Freshwater sponge is Spongilla. Mostly marine, few are freshwater. Freshwater sponge is Spongilla. Okay. same thing happens here also. They are mostly marine. Some exceptions have been found out, like freshwater cnidarian or coelenterate is Hydra vulgaris. So jo normal hydra hota hai uska naam, pura naam hai Hydra vulgaris, that is found in fresh water. And when we look at radiator, radiator are Ctenophora are exclusively marine. They are exclusively marine. So more about this we will discuss in our next class. If you have any questions, any queries, you can ask me. If not, bye-bye. Take care, happy studying. Ratamesh, at least keep 6, 7, 8 sheets at least. PDF of Neil search topics was already put up on the groups. I had already given it to ma'am. No, the postponed, the CA syllabus remains the same. CA syllabus mein sirf general properties aur core data aayega. ये जो डिटेल्स अभी हमने पढ़ा है, बाय द वे अभी तक हमने जो भी पढ़ा है वो हमने ऑलरेडी पढ़ा हुआ था, राइट? स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द ईयर हमने सारे फाइला का टेबल बनाया था जिसमें हमने ये सब वर्ड्स डाला था, सिनोनिम्स, बॉडी कैविटी, जर्म लेयर, ये सब लिखा था, राइट? सो नया कुछ नहीं आएगा, जो सिलेबस था वो सिलेबस वैसे का वैसे ही है. In fact, question paper भी पहले ही बन के all has been sent. Just some technical problems हो गया था app में. Okay. Can somebody, Devangi, goblet cell is an epithelial tissue, right? It's a columnar cell. Question was about connective tissue, so that's why that's the answer. Okay, which PPTs or which PDFs of Neil search topic is not opening? Can somebody write in the chat box? Okay, I will get to the bottom data. Anything else? Cell cycle and biomolecules. All right, bye bye then. Thank you very much.